Hey people, got a battle here against a friend of mine actually, Red Swings 1. This was for his 90 sub special. It was a great match, a roulette match. His link will be in the description, check him out. Like I said, it was for 90 subs, but now he's like way over 100. He'll be at 200 in no time. He is a really good YouTuber, so check him out. So, I get a Registeel lead. And I'm just going to take this time just to say how much I freaking hate Registeel, but he picked it, so what can I do? He gets a Persian lead, which is alright for him. He does fake out, does nothing to me at all. I predict the obvious taunts. Don't bother trying to set up Stealth Rock. Go for the U-turn. Yeah, no, I don't. I go for the Seismic Toss. And just big damage to Persian. He's only got like 200 and something HP. But it does nothing to this. Dunfan. So, I know he's going to set up rocks. It'd be a great time to get my rocks up, but I'm taunted, so I can't. I have two things I can switch into this Dunfan. I decide to play safe and switch into my Cradilli, because I don't think he can do anything to me, but this Dunfan has Toxic, which is really random. I don't think I've ever seen Toxic on a Dunfan before. But, yeah, this guy's unusual with his Dunfan, to say the least, as you'll see later. He goes for an Earthquake, and I'm Grass Rock, so it's neutral, and I think I'm max defense. I think. Because I'm supposed to be used in a Paz part of a Sandstorm team. And that will boost my special defense. So I think I'm max defense. It does nothing to me anyway. And I go for a Toxic, predicting him to switch, which he doesn't. I predict him to switch this turn. But he switches into a Weezing. So my Toxic doesn't do anything. Now, I know he's probably going to Flamethrower. But at the same time, I know it's not going to do anything to Registeel. So I can get him in safely and set up rocks. Just go for the Flamethrower. Like I said, it does absolutely nothing. But he gets the burn. Not too big of a deal, really, because it means I'm not going to be able to stay around as long. And it means that my explosion isn't going to do anything anymore, which kind of was annoying. It kind of mattered. But yeah, whatever. I do get up my rocks, and not sure what I do now. I think I just blow up. If I'd have not been burned, I'd have gone for an S-Toss, just to get some more damage on it, but I just blow up. It does, yeah, it does that much. Not much at all, really. So, Registeel down, I go out to my Ludicolo, would predict a switch on some rain, as he goes into his Persian, as probably Death Fodder, to be honest. Now, I don't want to take a fake out, so I switch into Scissor. And this isn't the Rain Dance Scissor you may have seen from a couple of videos. It's an old, very old one. I take a fake out really well. I am. My leftovers go here, so I think from that he deduced I wasn't banded, well, obviously I wasn't banded, but he deduced that I was going to be an SD Scissor, which was really nice on his part. He goes for the taunt. I was really hoping that he'd switch out for any bullet punch, but he doesn't. He stopped my SD, and that really good play. So I just go for X Scissor now on his Dunfan. It's a 2-hit KO with the poison, which is nice. I know, before anyone tries to leave a comment, that Bug Bite is stronger than Technician, but like I said, this Scissor is a Diamond Scissor, so it doesn't have, didn't learn Bug Bite until Heart Gold, I think, and it doesn't even have Bullet Punch because it didn't learn that to Platinum. And his Dunfan has the freaking Fire Fang, I mean, come on! Who has Fire Fang on the Dunfan? But thankfully, because of the rain, it didn't do much, and I think this is like a, this is really kind of bulky Scissor anyway, so I may have lived it anyway, depending on how many attack EVs you had. But I do live it. I take it out with a, was it not a 2-hit KO? Oh. Whatever. Yeah. So, he's dead anyway. He goes up to this Weezing again. I don't want to take a Will-O-Wisp or a Flamethrower. He goes for the Flamethrower as I switch into my Cradilli. Why is Dunfan, is Dunfan even dead? Why is this little thing not activated? Never mind. I really should watch instead of just talking. Anyway, I go for a recover as he switches out into Persian again as death fodder, and I make kind of a bad play here. It's not like a terrible play though, it was really quite stupid of me. I go into Lucario on the fake out, and I'm thinking there's a chance that Extreme Speed will scare him off and I'll be able to go for the Sword Dance. But there was no reason for him to switch because he died to Stealthrock anyway, so it was a really dumb play on my part. I go for the Extreme Speed, he does take it out with a crit, yay! And yeah, and he brings out this. I was terrified of this thing. I go out to my Cradilly trying to take a waterfall or whatever, but he's actually a Sub Puncher, which, yeah, that's bad. I'm gonna have to stay in that, try to break that sub. And he goes for an Ice Punch, which is super effective, but it doesn't kill me. So that was kind of a misplay on his part, because Focus Punch would have still been super effective, and it would have definitely killed me. Actually, no. I'll take that back, because I'd have broken the sub either way. Yeah, I take that back, because it gets left over more this way anyway. So yeah, not a bad play at all. So, I don't die. I'm gonna stay in here just in case he predicts the switch and tries to sub. And I die. Which, yeah, whatever. Seriously, this Donphan thing is trying to bug me now. I'm sure it's dead. Whatever. I go out to my Ludicolo. And I go for Grass Knot. And Azumarill is bulky. And it's not that heavy, so Grass Knot doesn't actually dig it out. It's one of the rare instances where Energy Ball would have been more useful. But I think he predicted, he definitely predicted the Rain Dance, as I thought he might, so he subs, and I get to take him out next turn with a Surf. So he brings out Gyarados, which is going to be a huge pain in my ass. I'm going to go for a Grass Knot, just because Gyarados is really, really heavy, so it's nice damage, and I see he outspeeds me, and I'm like, what? Who the hell runs Scarf Gyarados? Just, why? And then I see the leftovers. So I'm like, how did it outspeed me? And then I remember that because Swift Swim doubles speed instead of just 1.5, it doesn't actually need speed EVs to outspeed everything. So I didn't give my Ludicolo any speed EVs. I made it bulky instead. Which unfortunately means that there's a chance that crit you got with Stone Edge mattered. Because I could have lived that Stone Edge. If you got max damage, I think I would have died either way, but if you'd have got anything but max damage, I would have survived. But I'm not going to complain. Whatever. I got to Scissor. I SD up knowing I can take one of anything. Go for a quick attack. It was more than I thought, actually, but not enough to take it out. And I just died to the second one. I got to Earthrun now, and I make a kind of risky play. I go for the Protect, hoping he doesn't Dragon Dance. He doesn't. Whether or not he saw that coming, I don't know. Probably not, because Protect isn't that standard. I get my Toxic Orb boost, and he's not DD'd up at any point, so I know I'm going to outspeed. He withdraws his Gyarados, which is, you know, it's just going to die to Stealthrock, so whatever. I go for the Facade, doesn't kill the friggin' Weeding. That's where Explosion would have helped, because it would be dead, but it doesn't really make any much difference. It's just an extra turn of poison, really. So, Weeding's down. He has the two guys left. He brings in the Gyarados. It's just going to die to Stealthrock. And, you know, that's a son of a bitch. Doesn't die. It lives. I watched his video. It lives by one hit point. And he gets the Intimidate on me. And this means I'm at minus one now. And his last guy is a Hippowdon. I mean, come on. I have two physical attackers left. And he gets the second best physical wall in the game as his last guy. Not only that, but a physical wall who can one hit KO my Lucario. I mean, I wouldn't mind if he had Starm or Forest Dress, because I could set up on them, but yeah, whatever. Kind of funny in a way, because, you know, I picked it for him being a roulette, but whatever. My camera cut out there. As you can see, my Facade didn't kill him. This close combat isn't going to kill him either. he's going to live with a nice chunk of HP, and he's just going to finish me off with an earthquake. So that's a nice 1-0 victory, despite what my scoreboard says. The frigging Donphan's still alive. We'll have to change that. But yeah, great, great game. Red Swings, congrats on all the subs. If you liked the video, please press the like button. If you also press the subscribe button if you're not subscribed. I'm at like 295 when I'm narrating this, so please do subscribe. I want to get to 300 really, really badly. And yeah, see you all next time.